Painting your miniatures. The absolute bane of some people's existence, but a complete necessity if you want that nice looking army. But to others, it's the main part of their hobby, and they love painting all kinds of things. But one thing we mostly agree on is that grey and painted models, well, they kind of look a little bit shit sometimes, don't they? Now, for me, I love painting. It's the reason I got back into the hobby back in the day. I took a break, some of us do, and I got back into painting, and I never thought about playing the game for ages and ages. But a friend of mine, eventually, we got into playing, and now I do both. But for me, it still is all about the painting. Now, I love to buy models from all other gaming systems, not essentially just to play the game, but to just paint the models. I also love to paint all my board game miniatures, even though I probably never have time to play any of the board games, at least they look cool. And I'll just print models as well, you know, I have a 3D printer, I like to just print stuff as well and just paint it. Sometimes I have this real urge to paint a specific colour. And if you too, like this, then have this urge, it can come from anywhere. You know, maybe you have a favorite character, you like their design, or there's a design of something specific. Maybe you just always had a color that you've never painted before and you've always wanted to give it a try. Or maybe you were just somewhere and something caught your eye and it inspired you. For me, this color is orange. I've always loved the color, but I've never painted anything in this color. And I tried a long time ago. I had this notion that I was going to start a new homebrew Space Marine chapter, and they're going to be orange. But this is as far as I got, painting half a Centurion, and it's been sat on my shelf for years as a reminder that I never ever got around to finish him, or anything for that matter, in orange. Then Games Workshop released these guys, the Leagues of Votan. And it got me back into thinking, how can I apply this orange to a new army? Now, I thought about the leagues, and then I thought, no, I don't need another 40k army. At the time, we were playing a lot of Necromunda. So I thought to myself, how could I tie this into my Necromunda gang? So at the time, I was collecting Escher, so I'd already got my scheme sorted, and I thought, I like armor. Vansar, they have armor. Maybe I could try painting some orange Vansar. So I grabbed myself a box. I painted up these two guys as a test models, and I was happy with them. Which brings us to the point of the video. I'm just going to share my method and how I've done this, and all you need is a model and a primate light color. So gray sear, wraithbone, white, whatever you fancy. As long as it's light, we're going to use some contrast paints. So grab your model, let's go. And the first paint we're going to be using to get started with will be Magma Droth Flame from Games Workshop. It's a contrast paint. We're just going to cover majority of the model in it. So grab your paint, let's get started. Here I've got my model ready. It's been primed in Grey Seer by Citadel. Now just for just a little bit of clarification, I lost the first part of my video. So the model will change once we get to the next stages. So just be aware, I'm going to use this one as an example of our Magma Droth Flame. So all we're doing is we're just basing pretty much the entire model in the Magma Droth Flame. It's mostly going to cover all the armor parts, but all the bits we're going to do black as well, we're just going to cover majority of it. The only parts we're probably not going to cover are his weapons. And here we have it. So yes, the model has changed, apologies. But once it focuses, you can see that we have covered pretty much the entire model in the orange, apart from his hair, his gun, his face, and the little thing on the side of him. Moving on to the next stage, we're going to use some black. So I'm going to be using the contrast Black Legion from Games Workshop. And all we're going to do is we're going to find all the bits that are basically his undersuit, and we're just going to cover them in black. So if we have a look at our model, the bits we want to be black and will eventually be silver is sort of his underbody suit. So as you can see, the back of his legs are exposed. There's a little bit in between his lower back there. You've got joints in the shoulders. There's this little bit on the back that's going to be silver eventually. There's a bit in his abdomen here and his neckline. So if you look at it, it looks like they're wearing an underbody suit, and it comes right up to his sort of jawline and around the back of his neck. So do what you can to get in there. If you do get it on the orange armor, don't worry, because we haven't finalized that yet. So we can always come back round and sort that out. So the other things will just be hands, guns. Well, if hands, if you want him to look like he's wearing gloves. Mine are going to look like that. I don't like the sort of bare hand look. So all of his accessories, apart from his hair and his face, basically is what we'll be doing. Just a quick look at what has happened now. So I've got all the black in, done his weapon, I've done all in between his joints and everything, and all the underbody suit. I've managed to get the black all over the orange, which is fine because we will tidy that up. So if you have done the same as me and you've got it absolutely everywhere, do not worry about it, we can always clean it up. So yeah, just have a quick look. So basically his abdomen, all those cables I've got around his neck, inside there, on his head, that little cable. And we've done his gun, his accessories, the back of his legs, and anywhere in between, or sort of underneath his armpits and in between his elbows. One other thing I have also done is I've also got the bottom of the shoes as well. So I've gone a little line just to break up that orange. And it's an easily done on this one, because all you can do is you can just literally drag your brush across the side of it. So if you were just to like place your brush next to it, especially on this one when it's got that little box he's standing on, same on the bottom there, look, you can just put your brush next to it, the black on, and you can just literally glide it across nicely, and it'll just get the bottom of his shoes just like that. Anyway, that's enough of that. Let's get on to the next stage. Our next stage is just a cover-up stage. So grab the paint, whatever you've used to undercoat it. Here I'm using Grey Sear, as that's what I've sprayed mine with. And we're just going to apply it to any areas you might have got the black onto the orange. So it's just a simple step. As I mentioned, we're just going to take whatever colour you've used to prime your miniature in, and you're just going to cover up onto the areas where you might have got the black onto the orange. For me, I've got it in loads of places, so don't worry if you have, it's fine, we can fix it. Well, this is our stage to do that. So all we're going to do is just apply all over any areas where it is black and it shouldn't be. And it's not just his armor, so if you've got any of your paints on his braided hair bit or his skin, this is a good time as well to just reapply some of your base color over that and cover that all up again. Okay, so I've managed to do my little cover up. I've also based the stripes on his knee pads and his shoulder pads, if you can see. So I'll be doing them a whiter color later, but I've just applied the gray sear for now. So all I've done is I've just gone over all the parts where I have accidentally got the black onto the orange armor, and I've just covered it up with my gray sear. Next, we'll be moving back on to repainting it with the Magma Droth Flame. So get your orange back out and then cover up all these blotches we've got. On to the next stage. So we're going to work on the orange armor. So I'm going to be using Citadel's Troll Slayer Orange for the base, followed by Highlight Fire Dragon Bright. Now you can use any oranges you have. I have also done this and tried this out with Duncan's Fanatic Orange, and for a highlight I've used his Orange Flare. I've had great results with both paints. They both go on in a very similar manner. I'm only going with the Citadel ones because the orange that they do is just a bit brighter, and that's the kind of style or look I was after. Just to show you quickly a quick comparison, so they're both great paints, but as you can see, the Citadel on the right is just, it's just brighter. If it focuses, there we are. Duncan's great paint, it's just a shade darker, and I quite like my vibrant colours, so I'm going with the Citadel one. And at this stage, this is where we just have to be a bit more careful now. So I've thinned down my orange, and all I'm going to do is I'm just going to apply it all over the armour. I mean, it's pretty straightforward. Just get all the armor, leave all the recess areas shaded from the contrast paint. And what you'll have to do is, because it's a very thin paint, orange, you will have to make one or two passes. Now the way I do this is, I tend to start in an area, so some of the easy areas like the flat panels here and there. Put one layer on, as that's drying, sort of move around the model. Obviously go do other areas, and then as it's drying, keep coming back around. So I never really have to stop for it to dry at any point. I just keep going around the model doing all the different parts, and then I keep just rotating around and seeing where I've missed or where needs another layer. Or this is a good way to control your transition as well. If it's nice and sort of thin, you can just keep coming back round and applying the orange more and more where you want it to be brighter, and obviously leave it where you want it to be a bit darker. Just to clarify, I am letting pieces dry first before I apply my second layer. I just meant you don't have to let the whole model dry before you do your next layer. You can just sort of jump between. As long as the layers are dry, you'll be fine. For the next stage, you might be thinking, oh, we're going to do edge highlights. No, you're wrong. We're going to do the silver because, well, mainly for me, I'm a messy painter. I might get it on the orange again. I don't want to have to redo it all again. So I'm going to do the silver first, and then we'll do the edge highlights later. So all the areas we're going to be doing silver are going to be in his abdomen here, just sort of in the middle. There's like a rigid area, shall we say, that's the best way to describe it. Can't think of it any other way. It's going to be in the middle there. There's two little buckles as well. He's got like a little belt on, so you can get them as well. All the other parts, so his parts of his gun, the little thing on the side of him, his cables. We're all going to do this silver. There's a little bit on the back as well, so just the lower part of his spine, you can kind of see the it's a similar similar thing to the front. Yep, that's it. I hope that helps. And the bit at the back there, those cables that run over his shoulders, and we're going to leave that top part orange. Now you see that little sphere bit on the just on top of his back there, just to break it up a little bit. That's all, really. You don't have to, up to you guys. Again, this is your model, do what you want. I'm just showing you how I do mine. So I'm going to cover all this in silver, and then I'll just do anything else that I want to be silver. So again, it's up to you guys at this point. You can follow me or just do what you feel. So I'm just going to go through, that's it, do all the bits of his gun silver that I want silver, and so on. Right, I'll leave it there. We'll move on to the next part. It's time to wash those silver areas. So grab your black wash. I'm using non-oil. Grab whichever one you prefer, and let's go wash some metallic metal bits. Now, I just wanted to give a quick shout out to this silly little product that I bought from Games Workshop years and years ago. All it is just a little rubber molded triangle that fits your pots in. But I've put my three main washes that I use, and I have not spilt one since. I don't know if they still make it. If something similar is around, I highly recommend it, just because I used to knock these pots over all the time. I'm sure we've all been there. Brand new pot of non-oil, it's all over your desk. Anyway, back to it. And we're just going to take the non-oil and we're just going to apply it to all of the silver areas. Simple as that. Okay, people, whilst that black wash is drying, we're going to get the Ulthan Grey out, and we're just going to apply it to his shoulder pads, his knee pads, and that braid of hair that he's got. So I'm just going to take the grey, the Ulthan Grey that I'm using, and I'm just going to apply it to all the shoulder knee pads, all those stripes that we painted white earlier, or grey, sorry, white, not white yet, that's what we're aiming for. And I'm going to apply it to his luscious, long, braided lock of hair. Not quite sure what it is, but I'm sure somebody can tell me. Cool, and whilst that grey is drying, we're going to just apply a layer of pallid witch flesh to his face. So it's only going on his head and all of his skin area. Like I just mentioned, all we're going to do for this stage is we're just going to maybe have to apply one or two thin coats of this, because it's a very thin paint. And just to get it nice and smooth. So just do as many coats as you need, but all we're doing is we're just applying it to his skin, which on this is just his head. And the next step I'm jumping into is let's highlight some of this black. So I'm going to be using Eschen Grey as my first highlight on the black areas, and we're going to go over all of it. So grab your grey, let's go. Okay, so all we're going to do is take our Eschen Grey, and we're just going to highlight all of the black areas with this. So I'm going to run just some lines along his cables here. I'm going to pick out the creases and some of the areas on his trousers and all his undersuit. What we'll do is we'll also do a highlight on his weapons, just anywhere that's black, really. I'm just going to do a highlight of Eschen Grey. It's just a subtle colour. I quite like it. Now I'm going to do a full head wash of his hair and his face using this Soul Blight Grey from Citadel. We're just going to take it straight out of the pot. We're just going to apply it all over his hair and all over his face. So like I just mentioned, pretty simple. Just going to take it, the wash, and all we're going to do is apply one layer all over his head and all over his hair. And then we'll let that one dry. Okay, we're going to do some highlighting over the Eshin Grey, and I'm going to be using Dawnstone just to give it a bit more of a brighter highlight. So grab your grey and let's get highlighting again. So with your Dawnstone or whichever grey you are using, find all your bits where you've put your previous grey highlights, and we're just going to apply little bits of this over that highlight. So just to highlight it up a little bit more. So go around all the black areas, anywhere you've put that grey previously, and just highlight. Highlight away. Go for it. Okay, just jumping into the next step. I'm just highlighting the silver areas. So where we've recently washed it and dulled it down and darkened it a bit, I'm just going back over with my original silver, and I'm just going to paint all the raised areas before we do a final highlight on this silver. I'm just going to bring some of the color back with the original silver that we used. So grab your silver and just go over all your silver bits again. And I'm not sure if I could say silver anymore. Okay, so in this step, we're just going back to our Orthon Grey, or whichever grey you've used to put the base colour before the wash onto his hair. And we're just going to apply some highlights using that grey. So for me, it was the Orthon Grey. I'm just going to go over all of his braided area, and I'm just going to highlight it up using this grey again. And what I'll also do is just sort of apply it to his shoulder pads and his knee pads, just brighten them up a little bit. We've done the hair, we're going to go back onto the skin. So get your Pallid Witch Flesh back out, thin it down a little bit, and just highlight all of his skin area. And now it's time to do his armor. So we're going to highlight all of the armor. So grab whichever orange you decided to use, whichever's going to be your highlight. And now we're going to be super careful. And we're going to go around and we're just going to edge highlight all of the orange. For this step, try and be as neat as possible, obviously. But, you know, if you do mess up, we can just cover it up. So I'm not happy with some of these lines I've already done. That first line I did on this chest piece was a little too thick for my liking. So all I'm going to do is finish it all up, and then I'll come back round with my original orange. And what I'll do is I'll just try and thin those lines a bit. And then I might have to keep going back and forth because I'm not the greatest of painters. If I accidentally cover up all my highlighting lines, which I tend to do, I will have to redo them and back and forth. So just keep going and do it until you're happy with it. And then we'll move on to the next part. Before we move on to his eyes, I'm just going to drop a little bit of Agrax Earthshade into his eye sockets just to darken them down a bit and make those eyeballs a bit easier to see. Now this is the part where I'm going to try and block in his eyes a little bit. So I'm going to take some grey sear and I'm going to try and find his eyeballs. And what I'm going to try and do is just gently try and block in his eye. Now apologies if you really can't see this. I didn't realise the camera hadn't focused at this point. So let me just try and I'll hold it up to the camera and see if it'll focus. But I still don't think you can quite see what I've done with his eyes. But it is self-explanatory, you know. Just try and find the pupils or the eyes, the eyeballs, and try and get your color in there. Now we're just going to highlight his skin. So all I'm doing is I'm just mixing a bit of Skull White into the Pallid Witch Flesh, and then I'm just going to apply it to all the raised areas on his head. So his forehead, nose, ears, top of the head, anywhere that, you know, sort of catches the light, basically. That's what we're aiming for at this stage. So the next quick stage is, I wasn't happy with the highlights on the black. I thought they were a bit bit too much. They stand out a little too much. It's, you know, it's meant to look black. The grays are quite harsh. So I'm just going to thin down some of my non-oil. And all I'm going to do is just apply one coat over all the black areas where I think it might be a bit too much. It's mostly these cables, a little bit on the gun and everything. But if you have the same problem, if you think your grays might be, you know, too much and it's not black enough, just thin down some non-oil or whatever you've used for your black wash. Just apply one coat first, let it all dry because you won't see the effect straight away. Once it's dry, you can see how much it's sort of toned it down a little bit and tried to blend it in. If you're happy with that, leave it there. If not, just keep applying it until you're happy. Okay, so we're just going to highlight some silver. So grab a silver for this. I'm going to be using my Stormhost silver from Citadel. You can use any silver as long as it's a bit brighter than your previous silver we've used to base and wash it. Just grab anything and let's go. I just wanted to say silver one more time, so I don't think I said it enough. Silver! I'm just going to apply some highlights onto the silver areas just to bring it out a little bit, because at the moment it's just all one color with the wash on. We did go over it earlier with our original color. I don't have to do too much in this. And if you're happy with how it is, leave it. I'm just doing it just a little bit on some of the edge areas. Just sort of brings a little bit of color to it, doesn't it? Just a little bit of silver. So just go around, do all the silver bits, pick out any of the rivets as well, if there's any buttons, rivets, anything else that you might have missed that can be silver, you can pop them on right about now. I'm going to use some green here. I'm going to take my Wah Flesh, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply it to that little thing that's on the side of his leg. Not all the Avansar will have it, but for me it's like a little, I don't know what it is to be honest, but I'm going to put some green on it anyway. You can choose any colour, as long as it's a dark colour, we'll brighten it up in a second. Okay, so we're just going to take our green. I've watered it down quite a bit, to be honest. And all I'm going to do is I'm just going to drop it and blob it in here, essentially. And let just the color run into all the inside there. And I'm just going to let that dry. And what I'll try and do is, if I can, because there's a little needle in the middle, just try and remove some of the paint off of it for now. But you can always touch it up later. Jumping back into a highlight. I've got my gray here, so it's a light gray. I am just going to highlight some of the black areas. Not all of them, but some of them I want to be a little bit brighter. And all we're going to do with this grey is just over the real sort of edges of certain things. So mostly his gun. I'm just going to pop it along the edges here. So these sharp edges, just run the side of your brush across those edges just to get this grey onto it. And then pop it on some of the raised areas. It'll make it stand out a little bit more from some of the other blacks we've got on him, because there's a lot of black, and just to distinguish it, a slightly different type of material, I guess, because obviously that would be a harder substance, his weapon. You know, I'm going to make that a little bit more shiny in a sense, compared to his sort of undersuit, which in my mind, you know, it might be sort of a rubber or some kind of insulated material, so it might be a bit duller. It won't shine as bright as some hard plastics or metals. That's how I see it anyway, in my mind. Might be completely different, I might be completely wrong, but who knows? It's the 41st millennium. Anything could happen. Ooh. We're getting there, people. We're on the home stretch now. So the last bit, one of the last bits, is take a brown, a dark brown, any brown. I'm going to use Rhinox Hide. We're going to dry brush it just onto the end of the barrel of the gun. So this is going to give it a sort of burnt look. It's a real simple effect. It's not too hard. Let's give it a go. Right, so we've got our Rhinox Hide on our dry brush. So whichever dry brush you tend to use, just get some on there. And we're just going to apply it mostly to the silver bit. It doesn't matter if it goes everywhere else, really. If you imagine this is a melter gun, so a melter shot burst, it would probably cause some sort of heat damage to the end of the weapon. So I'm just going to try and get as much of it on the silver parts as I can, not all the way down. Obviously I want to just try and get most of the edge of it, but I want to leave enough brown along the barrel, because what we're going to do is apply a little bit of black just to sort of give it like a burnt edge afterwards. So I need enough brown on it so I can apply the black and still see a little bit of silver. And of course, to top it off, like I just said, we're going to get our black. So I'm actually using Duncan's Doom Death Black for this one. Same thing again. Simple. Yeah, it is pretty simple. Same thing. Just get a little bit on your dry brush and we're just going to brush the tip of the barrel. This is where we sort of apply our black, just to sort of the tip, really, as much as you can. Just a little bit on it, but enough that you can kind of see it's almost like a burnt edge, if you get what I'm going for. So the brown, obviously, will tint the metal, and you should have a little bit of metal showing through, and the black right on the edge, and that's all we're trying to do here. And if you've made it this far, you're still with me with my erratic painting schedule back and forth. We're jumping back again into the green thing we painted earlier on the side of his leg. Should hopefully be dry now. We've done the barrel and some other stuff. So get yourself a nice bright green. I'm using Moot Green here. And we're going to thin it down and apply it over the top of that last green. And getting your green then, I've watered this down a little bit as well. I'm just going to try and drop some in there just to give it a brighter, more illuminated effect. So the other green was just to sort of base it. And now what we're going to do is drop this sort of brighter green in. Try not to get on silver. If you do get on silver again, that's fine. Just go over it, cover it up afterwards. I just wanted it to be a bit brighter, like it's a, like I said, illuminated, isn't it? It's like a power pack, something's going on with it. I'm not quite sure what it is. But yes, I want to make it glow. So that's the reason for this. And with the silver, this is what I meant. We can just sort of go back over any bits we might have got the green on. And we can just tidy it up again. So always a tidy up stage, especially when you're painting like I do. And that actually brings us to the end. So once you've completed that stage, the only thing left to do will be to base it. And I won't show you how to base it in this one. If you are interested, if anybody's watching this, I could do that one day. However, everybody's probably got their own basing method. So all I've done is I've gone ahead and based mine. But everything we've done previous, that's it. We've finished him. And if you would like to see more close-ups of him, basically, what I'll do is I'll post him over on my Instagram account. So please go follow me over there, Kriegstar Collects. On Instagram, I'll do some snapshots of him. You can have a zoom in on my googly eyes I've painted. I still struggle with eyes. All my guys tend to look really shocked and horrored and like their eyes are bulging out of their skull. I think it's the eyelids. I need to work on that. But we'll get around to that. Anyway, sidetrack, rambling. Go ahead, have a look. Follow me there. Follow me on here. Comment, like, subscribe, do all that jazz. The usual YouTube stuff. That's about it really. So I'll hopefully hear from some of you. If you've made it this far, I really appreciate it. And I'd love to know if anybody has actually, enjoyed this and found it useful, really. And we'll keep making some more, hopefully. So until next time anyway, guys, if you've made it this far, like I said, I really appreciate it. Thank you very much. And hopefully I'll see you again. Till next time. Bye.